Base 10 or decimal is what everyone uses to count with, unless you're an American and have 12 inches per foot, 3 feet per yard, and 1,760 yards per mile. Makes much more sense.
What do you say?
Place the place in 10 times in value.
7? 6? 5? 4?
All your base, your base.
Base 1 unary or tally marks are the oldest counting system. The Ishango bone covered in tally marks is tens of thousands of years old.
2 and 2 are 4. 4 and 4 are 8. 8 and 8 are 16. 16 and 16 are 32.
2 and 2 are 4. 16 and 16 are 32.
The I Ching, or Book of Changes, was a very influential text on divination in ancient China. By tossing yarrow stalks or coins 3 times, a diviner would generate 1 of 8 trigrams, each of which has a word associated with it. A pair of trigrams also has an associated concept. Here we see the hexagram for pestilence, composed of the trigrams Harlem and Shake.
You can do the Harlem Shake.
Klingons use the three-adic system, which is like base 3, but digits run from 1 to 3 instead of from 0 to 2. Which makes me wonder, are there any Klingon waltzes? In base 10, the first few powers of 11 give the first few rows of Pascal's triangle. But it fails on 11 to the 5th. Because the tens in the middle overflow into the next digit. You can switch to base 100 and get the right answer for the 5th row, but on the 9th row, the 126s in the middle overflow. If we use a base that's transfinite, like the ordinal omega, or a base that's transcendental, like x, then it never overflows. So polynomials are base infinity. In factoratic, there's one digit for each base. The nth digit represents a quantity n times as big as the previous digit. The n-digit factoratic number gives a permutation of n digits. There are 2 dozen 4-digit factoratic numbers ranging from 1111 to 4321, and each gives a permutation of 4 items. If we connect each permutation to the ones we can reach with a single swap of 2 items, we get an n-1 dimensional permutahedron, which tessellates the space it lives in. Base Fibonacci works like binary, but instead of having 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 doubling each time, you have 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, the Fibonacci numbers. Since each Fibonacci number is the sum of the two before it, you never get 2 ones next to each other, just like the star-crossed lovers in the story of the Wolverine and the Moon, or the Weta and the Wind. So hopefully now when you're jumping between bases and things go wrong, you'll have a parachute and you can turn dying into flying.